Hey, welcome to the Espresso Outlet YouTube channel. My name is Barrett, and today we're going to take a look at this Nuova Simonelli Musica. So this is a cool little machine. It is an NSF rated machine, so if you're not very familiar with that, you need that NSF rating to start up maybe a coffee cart or a trailer, or to even have it in a restaurant. So that's really what this machine is great for. It's a nice smaller size. We'll go into more of the technical features here in a minute, but the smaller size means that it's very convenient to put on maybe a mobile coffee cart. So if we head over to the Espresso Outlet website, you'll notice that there's actually four different variants of this machine. The two main variants are there's a water tank version, which is what we have in front of us today, where you have a removable water tank. And then you also have a plumbable version as well. So if you have maybe a city water source with a water softener, you can plumb it in and pretty much have infinite water supply, or you could maybe plumb it into a 5-gallon flow jet or something similar. So those are your two main variants, and you can actually add a trim feature. It's called the Lux package, and you can add that to either the tank or the plumbable version. And what it does is it replaces these black bezels with a kind of an opaque acrylic looking plastic, and behind it it has LEDs. So it really makes your machine stand out. Maybe if you have a coffee cart and you're at a venue, people are gonna see it. It's gonna glow, it's gonna look really cool and look really fancy. So really nice trim feature. It does come at a little bit of a premium price, but it really might be worth it just for your company's branding. So with that, let's take a look at some of the specifics of this machine and maybe who it's used for. So we're gonna go over some of the features. This is a 120 volt machine. It takes about 1200 watts, so you can plug it into almost any receptacle. So if you were to bring this to a venue and not have your own generator, it's really easy to find power for this. You don't have 240 volts to worry about, or even a 20 amp receptacle that you need to go find. So that's pretty convenient. It has stainless steel body panels. It's smaller size. It's only 13 inches wide, so it really fits in very nicely on carts. 16 inches deep and 17 inches high. When we took a look at it versus the La Marzocco Linea Mini, it's fairly similar in size. I believe it was a little bit deeper in depth, but it was a little bit shorter. So really nice size, very comparable in size to that if you're looking for an alternative to that machine. This is a heat exchanger machine. So if you're not familiar with what a heat exchanger is, it actually has a single boiler with a second chamber. And your main chamber is what makes your brew water for your brew. And then you have a secondary heat exchanger built into that boiler to create your steam. So this machine does utilize a vibratory pump. The vibratory pump, they've kind of gotten a bad rap through the years because people think that they're a little bit loud, but I really don't find this machine to be that loud. In the front, you'll see that we have a hot water wand. In my opinion, this felt a little bit backwards compared to some of the rockets and some of the other machines that I've used, but really you're gonna get this machine and it's not gonna be a big deal. To turn on and off the water, simply depress the button. We'll let this fill back up and know that you can program this button. So if you're pulling Americanos and you want to have more or less of a timed volume that you want to top off your shot with, you can actually hit that button and it can be programmed. Which takes us over to our steam wand. Our steam wand has just loads of steam. Nice arm. This lever you can depress and it kind of springs back down into place, which is nice, but you can also lock it. So it creates a ton of steam, and I've really pushed it to the test and just left it open, and this thing will just keep creating steam all day long. So very powerful steam. I've really enjoyed the steam. I'm not real big on your milk drinks as much. So the steam wand, it is a no burn steam wand. The tip will get pretty hot still, so watch out. It does kind of have this little rubber insulator, which is nice so that you don't burn yourself, but you're not gonna get that built up milk crud on the steam wand. So while we're taking a look at the front, you actually do have your brew boiler bar gauge. So you know when your machine's heated up. It has this blue zone between 1.0 and 1.5. Mine's pretty much been in the middle every time that I've used the machine. Okay, so this is the water reservoir version. And to access the water reservoir, you just lift the door. It's quite simple. You can fill it up. I usually use a gallon jug with treated water and just top it off, but you will need to pull it out from time to time to give this a good wash. And if you just choose to fill it up this way, you can pull it out and fill it up with a different source. It does need to go in the proper direction. If you put it in backwards, there's actually a magnetic sensor on the side to know when the water tank is empty. There's also a trigger in there to know when you've removed the water tank so that it doesn't accidentally ruin your boilers by getting too hot. Now, this door does kind of take up some slightly valuable room for your cup warming tray. I didn't really find that this tray got like insanely hot, but it does get pretty nice and warm. If you're rotating cups out, it's not gonna stay maybe as warm as some of those really big machines that just have tons and tons of heat coming out of them. So a lot of people using this are probably gonna be using maybe a paper cup if you're using it on maybe a cart, but if you're using it at your home, I think you're gonna find the warming tray to be perfectly acceptable. So the drip tray has quite a bit of room in it. It's easily removable. You just kind of lift up on it slightly and pull it out, and you can remove your top grate to dump or clean your drip tray. So it has quite a bit of room. You will need to probably empty this out regularly if you don't have it plumbed, but it's really not that big of a deal. I felt like it's held a lot more water than many of the other machines that are on the market of this size. Okay, so let's take a quick look. There's really no like LCD display or anything on top, so very simple. But to go through the programming modes, you may need to do a little bit of reading. We're gonna do a separate video on that. But to go over the buttons real quick and the lights, this is for your hot water. This is pre-programmable for a single or double. It's just however long you program these two. So you can actually have two different programs in there. The middle one is just an on-off start stop. So it is a non-programmable button. And it's really nice for just trying to dial in your machine and not using these volumetric features. And then the last button over here is your power button. So there is actually a master hard power switch in the back, but it's a little bit hard to get to, so you can press and hold that to turn on and off your machine. There are two lights in the front, and I found these to be very convenient, especially since this is the water tank version. So you'll want to know when you're out of water and top this machine off so it doesn't start cooling off. You'll see this water pitcher light up, and you can just top off the water tank. Similarly, as your machine's heating up, this is just for your heating element. You'll see it turn on and off throughout using the machine, but for the most part, it's gonna stay off. You'll see it just flicker on and off. As it's heating up, you will see it just constantly on. So that's one way of knowing that your machine is almost heated up when you see that turn off. You can also check your brew boiler bar gauge below. So these buttons are programmable, and that makes it really nice if you have maybe some less experienced baristas and you come in, you dial in your grinder, and then you dial in and say, if they're buying this drink, use this one. If they're buying that drink, use that one. These are really quick and easy to change, so don't worry about that. Okay, so we've covered a lot of the pros of this machine, and there's really not too many cons, but we'll go through a few of the things that you just might want to know about. I don't really find them as deal breakers, but just pointing them out, they're kind of just the cons in my opinion if I was going to look at this machine. So this is a pressure stat machine, meaning that instead of it having a PID, which is kind of like a thermostat for your machine that you can program, you actually have a pressure stat. Now, you can adjust this pressure stat really easily. If you remove the drip tray, I have a different video. There's a small plastic plug that you can remove, and you can use a screwdriver to adjust that pressure stat. You're pretty much just gonna set it once, and you're probably never gonna mess with it again. But it's nice to have that PID feature. It's not really a must, and I think it works well for this machine having the pressure stat. The next thing that I found is not really a deal breaker because you can buy portafilters for the Nuovas about anywhere, but the Nuova has opted for this kind of like diagonal ear pattern. So if you were to go just try to find a standard 58 millimeter aftermarket like bottomless, let's say, you're gonna have to go buy a Nuova one, and they do sell them, so it's not a big deal and they're really not that expensive. But your standard 58, you can kind of see, is straight across with these tabs, and this one they're at an angle. So just trying to go pick up a standard 58 is not quite as easy. A lot of your restaurant and your technicians, they carry these, so it's really not a big deal. Now, if you're using this in a busy cart, I'd probably recommend picking up a couple of portafilters. Figure out which one works for you. I find the single spout, and this is just for every machine out there, they're a little bit hard to tamp because you have that single spout and it wants to rock to the side. Where when you have your double spout, it'll actually kind of self-level itself. If you have a bottomless, it can kind of get some coffee grounds on the bottom, but it also levels itself nicely as well. So I would probably pick up a couple extra portafilters, and if you so choose, maybe a slightly larger basket. The baskets that came with this I found to be quite nice. I actually threw an aftermarket basket into this single spout. So this is what I've been using for this straight espresso, and this works really well for your milk drinks. So really not too many cons. If you do have the water tank version, you will need to fill it up. If you have the plumbable version, depending on how you're set up, like if you have a trailer with a large water supply, you're obviously just gonna have it plumbed in. It's gonna be really easy to use. But if you're on a cart, it might be a little bit more difficult. So you may end up having to clean this drip tray out if you do a lot of purges, since this is a heat exchanger machine. If it goes 5-10 minutes without pulling a shot, you may do a quick purge to get some of the residual heat out of the group head, and that might fill up that drip tray a little bit quicker. Just know that you're gonna need a sink or something to dump that out in. Just to go over a few more of the features on this machine, this is a thermocompensated group head, meaning that it's gonna have hot water heat your portafilter, which is really important to brew a nice espresso. You don't want it to hit that cold group head and then you have all these temperature swings. So something that's really cool about this machine is it actually has a factory preset pre-infusion. So it's gonna start out with a lower pressure and ramp up. Now this is programmable. It's actually two layers deep in the programming menu. Again, we're not gonna cover that today, but know that it does have a pre-infusion built in and that you can change it if you choose. I forgot to mention during the steam wand that this is a four hole steam tip. So it delivers just loads of steam. Okay, so that pretty much wraps up the Nuova Simonelli Musica. If you have any questions about this machine, it's best to go to espressooutlet.net and shoot us an email. So if you're thinking about buying one of these machines, that's the best way to reach out. And maybe we can pair a bundle together if you need an espresso grinder. Any other questions about any other similar machines, just feel free to reach out. Just wrapping this one up, I really feel like this one is a really good coffee cart or small trailer or for a small restaurant. It's gonna be your lower volume machine. If you're starting a larger cafe, this is probably not the machine for you, but a lot of people, they don't need some $10,000 machine. They just need to pull a couple shots an hour. And this will do that and more with ease. So this is the Nuova Simonelli Musica. Hit subscribe on our channel and feel free to reach out if you got any future questions. Thanks for watching.